What is a shift reduce parser? Shift reduce parsing is a process of reducing a string to the start of symbol of a grammar. Shift reduce parsing uses a stack to hold the grammar and input tape into the string. So let's see what are some of the basic operation of shift reduce parse. It involves shift, reduce, accept and error. A shift involves moving of symbols from an input buffer onto the stack. In reduce, it handles if the handle appears on the top of the stack, then it is reduced by an appropriate production rule. In accept, if only start symbol is present in the stack and the input buffer is empty, then the parsing action is called accept. In error, this is the situation in which the parser can neither perform shift action nor reduce action and not even accept action. So what are the types of shift reduced parser? In the diagram, we can see that LR parser is a type of bottom up parser, and the types of LR parser are LR0, SLR1, LALR1 and CLR1. So let's start with LR0 parser. An LR0 item is a production G with dot at some position on the right side of the production. LR0 item is useful to indicate that how much of the input has been scanned up to a given point in the process of parsing. In LR0, we place the reduce node in the entire row. This is the DFA for LR0 parser, and this is the parser table for LR0 parser. And here we can see the states I0 to I6. And from SLR1 parser, Akash Banerjee will continue.
Thank you, Aritra. So here we have the SLR parser. So as we know that SLR is actually the simple LR parsing. It is quite similar to LR0 parsing, only we see the difference when we actually put them in the parsing table. So when we move on to the next slide, we see that we have the drawing DFA. And here we see that we have 9 states in total, ranging from I0 to I8. Next, moving on to the parsing table of SLR1, we see that all the states are defined here, as well as the actions of each state and where they are moving to. So we have everything set up, and next we have there is LALR parser. LALR stands for look ahead LR parser. We construct the LALR parser based on the canonical collection of the LR1 items which we get from the LR1 parsing table. And when we move on to the next slide, we see that we have the DFA of it. This contains the 7 states in LALR1, and ranging from I0, if you could go back, thank you. Ranging from I0, I1, I2, and I3, 6, 4, 7, 5, and 8, 9, which makes all the 7 states. Now moving on to the next one, we see that we have all the 7 states arranged as well, and also the starting positions and the ending positions for each states as mentioned in the table. So next up, we see the CLR parser. CLR is basically known as the canonical look-ahead parser. So this parser is also built on the canonical collection of LR1 items using the CLR1 parsing table. So another interesting fact for the CLR parsing table is that we see that it produces a greater number of states than the SLR1 parsing table. So in the next slide, we will also see the DFA of the CLR parsing table, and we see that there are a lot much more number of parsing states than we have seen in the previous states as we are mentioning. Here we have 10 states in total, ranging from I0 to I9. The next slide will show us the parsing table. As we can see, there are the states ranging from I0 and I9, and there are also the states in which they will be moving from one to the next slide. The next slide will be having the gate questions, which will be presented to you by our third member, Arjit Dev. Arijit, if you can please present it.
Yes, Akash, thank you, and good evening, everyone. So here we got some gate question. And number one, which of the following statements are true? Number one, SLR parser is more powerful than LALR. Number B, LALR parser is more powerful than canonical LR parser. Number C, canonical LR parser is more powerful than LALR parser. And D, the parser SLR, canonical LR and LALR have the same power. And the answer is C, that is canonical LR parser is more powerful than LALR parser. Canonical LR parser is the strongest of all parsing techniques available. Okay, so moving to the number two question. Which of the following statement is false? A, an ambiguous grammar has same leftmost and rightmost derivation. Number B, an LL1 parser is a top-down parser. Number C, LALR is more powerful than SLR. And D, an ambiguous grammar can never be K for any K. The answer is A, that is an ambiguous grammar has same leftmost and rightmost derivation. What is the explanation? That is, the ambiguous grammar can never have same leftmost and rightmost derivation because of its ambiguity. Okay, so on to the number three question. Which of the following suffices to convert an arbitrary CFG to an LL1 grammar? The answer is none of this. Explanation, removing left recursion and factoring the grammar do not suffice to convert an arbitrary CFG to LL1 grammar. Number four. Next. In a bottom-up evolution of a syntax-directed definition, inherited attributes can be evaluated only if the definition is L-attributed. Explanation, a syntax-directed definition, SDD, is called S-attributed if it has only synthesized attributes. L-attributed definition contain both synthesis and inherited attributes but not need to build a dependency graph to evaluate them. The next question is number five. The grammar A is double A or bracket of whole A and or end is not suitable for predictive parsing because the grammar is ambiguous. Explanation. For predictive parsing, grammar should be free from ambiguity, free from left recursion, and free from left factoring. Even grammar both contains both ambiguity and left factoring, so it cannot have predictive parsing.
And with that, we come to our conclusion. So the main conclusion to be drawn from the reports discussed above is that the influence of the grammar can hardly be underestimated. That was the end of our presentation.
Okay, thank you. Very good presentation. I like the presentation, but now, why LR1 is very interesting? Because initially, whenever we started the parsing topic, we found that if it is a parsing can be done by brute force method, maybe solve all. Okay, you don't need LL1, LR1. Brute force technique from the top down, but the problem is there is back and forth recursion and all this problem. It cannot be done O(n), so we try to make it O(n). So we have to go for LL1. For LL1, there will be no recursion, there will be no left factoring should have to be improved, and no left recursion. That is not also guaranteed that it can be LL1 grammar. Actually, you have make a parsing table so that every parsing table should have a unique entry. That's it. But the same logic goes to, but this whole thing, this LR1 is invented by Donald Knuth. He's one of the very influential computer scientists. After Alan Turing, von Neumann, Donald Knuth, this gentleman come, then Donald Knuth is there, Jaksa is there. They are tremendous. They are basically, make the foundations of this computer science. So LR1 is very not easy to understand because first there is a shift reduce, then the handle should be always at the top. So any unambiguous grammar for bottom-up parsing, the handle should be one and only unique one, and that should occur only at the top of the stack. So then the concept comes the LR0 items, canonical collection and all this. So top of the stack is the basically stack state where you have mentioned I0, some books say S0, someone meant 0 and 1. You have given the diagram excellent, but critical point is how to make these state numbers, how to available these state numbers from the augmented grammar. I will try to show, some of you have already done. I try to show in a board work. So then augmented grammar, then you make a LR0 items, then LR0 items some sort of limitation. Sometimes it reduce, it go repeated to all the rows. So whenever you go for LR1, number of states should be much, but number of states generally may be 100 times more than LR0. LR1 is still powerful, but there is lot of questions still now. There are some grammar, LR1 obviously unambiguous. There are some unambiguous grammar without the reach of LR1 also. So it is not that all the unambiguous deterministic grammar can be parsed by LR1. LR2 or LRK, it can detect more powerful grammar. So there is always a research topic is there, because parsing is very essential for any computer scientist job. Like I have told, your CPUs are evolving, changing. It comes from Intel, then the RISC chip, ARM chips, and they are having GPUs are also coming. Cloud computing is there. That is the CPU portion is hardware is ever changing. Software is also there is a lot virtual machine based software like Python, Java, like this, and so it can also goes to cloud. So who does this all these things matching the software and hardware? They are basically compilers and interpreters. So that is always a research topic, and I believe LR1 is always, if you understand LR1, how the state information goes, how the parsing table goes, that is one of the great thing, because later on we see maybe machine intelligence and all these things, artificial intelligence, are coming into the parsing.